This is probably the most influential illustration of the dodo, a painting by Roland Safari from 1626 known as the Edward's Dodo. This painting has been used as a reference for many other dodo illustrations. It was even used by biologist Richard Owen in 1866 to base his postcranial anatomy description of the dodo. However, the credibility of this painting has been questioned. Dodo remains are hard to come by. Out of 12 identified near-complete skeletons, only one is non-composite. Limited specimens and an abundance of assumptions and misinterpretations conceal the dodo's true appearance. We are still not completely sure what the dodo looked like, how it behaved, when exactly it went extinct, and even the origin of the name dodo itself is obscure at best. The dodo, the icon of extinction, is jumbled in mystery. This is a Mauritian 10 rupees coin. On one side it features a dodo. Dodos were native to the island of Mauritius, some 2,000 kilometers off the southeast coast of Africa in the Indian Ocean. Together with Reunion and Rodriguez, they make up the Mascarene Islands, home to many unique endemic species of plants and animals, and the dodo is the most well-known among them. The dodo has been featured in many forms of artworks, where it has mostly been used as an icon for extinction and obsolescence. But despite the dodo's prevalent presence in pop culture, little is known about the bird's biology. The majority of dodo remains are subfossil specimens from the Mawusonj swamp. There are hundreds of dodo remains found from the bottom of this swamp, but all are incomplete. Most are missing their skulls and wing bones. There is only one complete skeleton of an individual dodo, and since there is no taxidermy specimen that remains today, apart from a dried head known as the Oxford dodo, figuring out the dodo's appearance in life is difficult. The coloring and plumage of the dodo are not known for sure, and weight estimates vary significantly, from a whopping 27 kilograms to as little as 10 kilograms. There is very little physical evidence of the dodo's external appearance, which makes illustrations and written accounts from the 17th century particularly important. Unfortunately, not all illustrations are reliable, and since the depictions vary considerably from one portrayal to another, definitive evidence is difficult to ascertain. The variability in the depictions led some ornithologists to speculate about sexual dimorphism, seasonal variant, ontogenetic traits, even the existence of different dodo species as the reason behind the inconsistencies. However, it is impossible to determine if these illustrated details mean anything, or if they even reflect reality at all. It is unclear which 17th century illustrations were drawn from the live animal, and which were based on stuffed specimens. Many seem to depict the dodo as very fat, which might happen when the artist referenced a crudely stuffed specimen. The only known dodo illustrations that were drawn based on the real bird directly on Mauritius are these sketches by Joris Joost and Slaarle. Written accounts describing the dodos are mostly found in ships' logs and journals of the Dutch East India Company ships, but most are also not reliable since many were written based on earlier accounts and none was written by scientists. To add up to the confusion, rumors about the existence of a rather cryptid white dodo in a neighboring island Reunion emerged. Reports in 1625 mention a white, stocky, flightless bird in Reunion. And a different travel journal from 1619 also mentioned a fat, flightless bird, which was published in 1646 with an unrelated illustration of a dodo. Later, paintings of the supposed white dodo surfaced in the 19th century, which prompted several writers to make sporadic mentions about the existence of the Reunion white dodo. A name was addressed for this vague animal, and a variety of speculations about the true identity of white dodo followed. But later, it was figured out that the white dodo paintings were based on another painting that referenced a stuffed specimen in Prague. Maybe the white color was meant to depict an albino individual. The color could also be the result of juvenile trade, bleached old taxidermy specimens, or merely an artistic purpose. And the flightless bird mentioned in the journals was presumably the now also extinct Reunion ibis, The most accurate depiction of a living dodo came from a 17th century Indian Mughal painting, thought to have been the work of Ustad Mansur. It shows a much slimmer bird with brownish plumage, which is consistent with our current knowledge, and the surrounding birds are also accurately depicted. It might have been drawn from a living bird kept in the menagerie of the Mughal Emperor Jahangir in Surat, India. The same place where an English traveller, Peter Mundy, claimed to have seen a couple of living dodos between 1628 to 1633. Compare it to Safari's painting from earlier, they may as well depict two different animals. Safari claimed that his dodos were painted from real-life birds, but evidence shows that the improper representation means that he only saw preserved specimens. Julian Hume, a paleontologist with a particular interest in the dodo, argued that the living dodo had a slit nostril. Thus, it can be inferred that paintings with gaping nostrils were modeled after dried taxidermy specimens. Around 1638, reports mentioning the dodo became rarer, and it seems all illustrations after this time were copied or based on earlier images and not drawn from the real bird. During the second Dutch expedition to Indonesia in 1598, the Dutch used Mauritius as a refreshing station for the Dutch East India Company ships. The dodo was first mentioned by Dutch travelers, but they didn't name them dodo. When first discovered, the Dutch called them Valkvogel, which translates to disgusting bird. Unlike the passenger pigeons, reports of the taste of dodo meat often described it to be unsavory and hard. The word duonde, meaning swollen, was also used to refer to the dodo by the crew of the Dutch ship Helderland. Another theory states that the name was simply an onomatopoeic approximation of the bird's call, a two-note pigeon-like sound. The earliest record of the name dodo, instead, came from a letter in England, and writer Sir Thomas Herbert also used the word dodo in his travelogue in 1634. Both accounts claim that the word was of Portuguese origin, presumably derived from the word doido, meaning foolish. The origin of the name is unclear, because although the Portuguese did visit Mauritius in the early 16th century, they never mentioned the bird, nor the name dodo. The dodo acquired fearlessness and lost the ability to fly from the absence of predators on the island for millions of years. When humans arrived, they became an easy prey. But it wasn't human hunting that killed off the dodos, it was animals brought by humans, mainly pigs and macaques, that did the bulk of the damage. They outcompeted the dodos for food and plundered their nests. Since the dodos had no natural predators on the island, they probably nested on the ground and laid a single egg clutch, which made them particularly vulnerable. Combined with deforestation that destroyed their habitat, the dodos and many other island inhabitants had no chance in surviving the ordeal. The red rail, the broad-billed parrot, the Mauritius blue pigeon, the Mauritius owl, the Mauritian shelduck, the mascarene teal, the Mauritian night heron, the small Mauritian flying fox, the Mauritian giant skink, round island burrowing boa, and two giant tortoise species also fell victim to human activities and disappeared. Numerous species of plants and invertebrates also became extinct, and many neighboring islands' inhabitants also saw a similar fate. Needless to say, the Mauritian ecosystem was badly damaged. The dodo went extinct sometime in the 17th century, but was not recognized until two centuries later. This was partly because many believed the dodo was a myth and had never existed. Also, extinction was thought to be impossible due to religious beliefs. The exact date of the dodo's extinction is still unknown, and is unlikely to be resolved. A 2003 statistical analysis of records mentioning dodo sightings gave an estimate to as late as 1797. But in a 1668 account by an English traveller, the red rail was mentioned as red hen and dodo interchangeably, indicating that the name dodo was commonly used to refer to the red rails after the actual dodo had disappeared. A more recent estimate from 2020 suggested that the dodo went extinct due to predation by pigs in 1658 to 1664. So all mentions of dodo afterwards actually referred to the red rail. The name was transferred inadvertently, since the dodo's extinction was not realized at the time, and numerous settlers expected to see flightless birds but had never seen one. They then assumed the name dodo to the red whale instead. This rationale was accepted by the IUCN Red List, and 1662 was chosen as the extinction year of the dodo. This means that the dodo survived for just 64 years after it was discovered by humans. Scientific evidence described the dodo as noticeably dissimilar from its popular culture interpretation. The fat, clumsy, and stupid dodo is the product of confusion and imagination by those who are fascinated by the dodo's mysterious nature, and it does not represent the actual enigma that once roamed the jungles of Mauritius. The dodos did not flee from hunters, and were called stupid for this reason. On the contrary, computer scans of the bird's skull determined that the dodo had a relatively big brain, indicative of high levels of intelligence. The dodos were actually not the fat, clumsy birds as it's commonly depicted. They were well adapted to their ecosystem. A study of the dodo's leg bones suggested that the bird was able to run quite fast, was agile and well suited to wander about the dense jungle terrain of Mauritius. Evidence of natural disasters such as flash floods, volcanic activities, and droughts had caused mass mortalities to the inhabitants of Mauritius. Yet, the dodo survived these natural disasters, proving that they were resilient within their ecosystem. The dodo became an icon, a legend, an animal that made us realize that human-induced extinction was not only possible, but it actually happened in a surprisingly short time, reducing weird and wonderful animals into mere myths and stories of the past. Consistent with its connotation, the dodo is dead, and how it lived in its natural habitat will persist as a mystery.